I love films and I love science, but sometimes the two just don't get along.
Kind of like a computer virus, you somehow program to blow up an alien spaceship with an Apple PowerBook running Mac OS 7.5.2. Some films try hard to be scientifically accurate. Take Interstellar, Christopher Nolan's epic space exploration movie, and destroy of surround sound speakers. The film's consultant, the theoretical physicist Kip Thorne, actually provided the mathematics for the FX team to generate what wormholes and the bending of space-time would look like. Accuracy was the key word director James Cameron used to boast about the detail of everything in Titanic, from the ship's decor to the physics of how the ocean liner broke into two. However, scientist and astronomical nitpicker Neil deGrasse Tyson pointed out the stars in the sky were incorrect for that specific location and date in 1912. Neil Tyson's nitpicking didn't stop there.
The beginning of your program? Your Earth is spinning the wrong direction.
Son of a bitch!
I'm sorry, I had to get that off my chest.
But it's hard to be totally accurate when you're portraying science on screen, especially if you're Neil deGrasse Tyson in your own documentary, flying in a spacecraft that makes noise. Despite the fact that vacuum in space does not conduct sound. Isn't that right, Neil? One film that doesn't let science get in the way of a good story is Michael Bay's Armageddon. Amazingly, this asteroid-themed disaster movie is actually shown to trainees at NASA, but as a test to see if they can find the 168 impossible moments of bullshit. Like Ben Affleck crash landing on the asteroid and surveying the burning wreckage. Burning despite the fact there's no oxygen for the fire to burn. Or instead of a vertical takeoff like every rocket ever built, the space shuttle takes off from the asteroid horizontally, like a plane taking off from a runway, despite the fact there's no air for the wings to provide lift. Angry physicists have even written papers discussing the science of blowing up the asteroid. Could Bruce Willis save the world? No. He would have to have the equivalent of a million nuclear arsenals. Although he received more favourable results in the paper, Could Bruce Willis Save a Terrorist Besieged Skyscraper on Christmas Eve?
Yippee-ki-yay, mother...
But perhaps the biggest science faux pas of all time undermines the entire plot of the Jurassic Park trilogy. Let's take a look at this amber-preserved mosquito. You know, the one with the dinosaur blood. You know, the basis for the whole film. Yes, it did exist through the time of the dinosaurs. But this species of mosquito doesn't eat any blood. So, can Hollywood ever make a scientifically accurate movie? Yes. Except if the fate of the planet Earth is at stake, because then artistic license is more important.